So I, on behalf of all of the participants, I welcome Shri Anandji for this program.
Hello.
So we can have good discussions and free discussions here. You can have questions. It will be free questions. It will be on anything on spirituality, and then you will get a reply on this here itself. And moreover, that if you get doubts, then you can also discuss and clarify also. So those who want to raise the question, kindly use that hands raised option. Or Sanjay ji has come from Rajasthan. I'll give unmute.
Namaskar, Anand.
Namaskar, namaskar.
Hi.
Hiya ji. Good.
Hi, namaskar. Yeah. So the question that
he's got
muted.
No, yeah, yes, he has got muted. Sanjay ji, you have to unmute yourself. Unmute.
Maybe he's got some connectivity issues.
Yeah, some connectivity issue maybe. Okay, if somebody else wants to raise the question, kindly raise the hands option. You are one more.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Anyway, the light is not sufficient.
I think I got disconnected.
Yeah, yes. Please. Yeah. Now it's all right.
Yeah. So yes, I wanted to ask that thing that the reply that you had sent in the morning, that maybe I am seeing the fact, but my mind is not accepting it, that it doesn't have any role to play in the psychological world, or it doesn't have any right to set right the psychological state. Now, that doubt which I raised was that in this state of confusion, do I simply accept it, or should I do some action to set right this stage of psychological confusion?
Yeah. So if you're talking about the understanding of this, right, this concept, so what we are saying is very simple, right? These thoughts and emotions are not under our control. This is the core statement, core concept of this. So if you have confusion, or if you are not able to accept this, and which means you are saying it is under your control. That is what you're trying to say, right? That's what you feel, right?
No, actually, so, I don't have any doubt that I know that thoughts and emotions are not in my control. But then this understanding, as you say, that it is not operating because you know it, but your mind is not convinced.
No. So, your knowing is fine, but are you able to accept it, or you're trying to change it, right? You want to. So what is the exact problem?
No, I'm not trying to change.
So what is the problem then? Yeah, understand.
The problem is that I know that it is okay, that it is a fact that I cannot change the thoughts and emotions.
Correct.
Okay. So, yeah. But then this, see, when I ask questions, then I get the answer so that you will say that, okay, then if doubts and confusions are there, then let them be.
Yeah. So if you are clear, if you are able to accept that these are not under your control, then whatever happens next, you cannot question that, right? So either you have to take the either of these sides, right? Or if you're not able to accept, then you can inquire. There is no problem. There is nothing wrong in it. You can test it out. You can take more time, try it out for some more time and check for yourself. You don't
so
have
let
to
us
conclude.
Say I'm not able to accept. Then what do I do?
That's what. So
how do I make it accept?
Correct. So when you say you're not able to accept, it means that you're saying you have control. You can try to, change your thoughts and emotions. That's what it means, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. So then you can try it out. That's what I'm saying. You try to experiment. You try it in various different scenarios, whether you are able to bring this under control. So if you try it out and test it out for yourself in various situations, then you will obviously after some time, you can do it, how many ever times you want, in various situations, then you will come to a conclusion one day, right? So there is nothing wrong in it. You can test it out and come to a conclusion. You don't have to simply believe that this is how it is working. That's the
I have come to a conclusion that I have some control. I mean, it is not entirely out of my control. Correct. Like if I'm I'm in a gloomy mood, then I can probably watch some TV or read good books, so my mood elevates.
Correct.
So some control is there.
Yeah. Correct. So what is the problem that you want to address then?
I mean that the thing that you say that thoughts and emotions are not in your control. So I'm saying thoughts or emotions are to a large extent not in my control, but it is not that they are entirely out of my control.
Yeah. Correct. So that is what. So those thoughts or whatever your actions you do, like watching a movie, etc., that's an external action, right? When you feel bored or something, like you're going for a movie or whatever, music, etc., that's an external activity that you're doing. That's possible. There is nothing wrong in it. You are thinking about it and you're getting engaged in an external action. So that's absolutely fine.
Then what is internal action?
Internal action is expecting that I should be always peaceful. I should be feeling satisfied. I should be, that silence, calmness.
Yes, that expectation. I mean, I would say that there is no such expectation that I should always be happy, but there is always a desire that I should be happy.
Correct. Let that be. You don't have you're not desiring it on your own consciously, right? Because you know that you cannot desire. Even if you desire, it is not going to work. You're clear on that, right?
Yeah, I'm clear that it may not work. It doesn't work, but that desire is there.
Yeah, let it be. That's what I'm saying. Desire is not, you cannot, so desire is there means you're trying to only say that it should not be there. Are you trying to say it should not be there?
No, it should be there.
Yeah, that's all.
It can be there.
Let it be there. So the point is whether it is there or not, it is not our problem and we don't have to worry about it because that is how mind will work. Whatever situation you are engaged in, some emotion, some thoughts will keep popping up. That is what we are saying, right? So something will be there. Desire will be there. Confusion will be there. Happiness will be there sometimes. Sorrow will be there. Anger will be there. Anxiety will be there. Everything will be there. Which everything will be in a continuous flow. You don't have to halt the system or keep checking every moment saying, what is this happening right now? Is it good or bad? You don't have to judge each and every moment of what is happening inside. So the overall system, the psychological system, which is those thoughts and emotions are not under our control. That much, if you understand, that is sufficient. Mm-hmm. After that, if you're questioning that why I'm not, why this desire is there or why this sorrow is there, etc., then that's what it indirectly means that you want to make the opposite. You are wishing for the opposite status. So that is what, then you are going against the concept. That's what I was trying to say, that indirectly you're again going against the natural flow that is already there. if desire comes, let it come. That's all. Allow that also.
And sometimes I can actually change my emotions by internal action, not necessarily external action. Like the example I was giving, it was about daydreaming. So I can actually start daydreaming some pleasant thoughts and my mood elevates.
Yeah.
So that is not an external action, but then I can control my mood through that action.
Yeah.
Which so is that entirely is psychological action.
Correct. So you can only consciously doing it. It's a thinking, right? That's what we are saying. Whatever you consciously do is the thinking, uh-huh. which you manually do it. If you are feeling nice about it, you can do it. There is nothing wrong. There is no rule that you should do this and you should not do these things. So you have to understand this concept doesn't say that these are the only things you should do and these are the things you should not do. We are not trying to give a philosophy or a set of commandments that these are the things you should do and not do. So we are only trying to point. I'm just pointing my finger and trying to point out a scientific fact that this is how it is working. So according to that, you can manage your activities, you know, accordingly. You don't have to follow any rule here. Only rule, all rules are only in the external world activities, because that's an artificial society that we have created, artificial arrangement. Internally, there is no arrangement is needed. There is no, you don't have to keep arranged it in a proper order. Nothing of that sort is needed, because it is all natural. Everything, you just have to simply give a tick mark to everything.
At that point, it still stands that through internal action also, you can sometimes influence your moods and emotions.
Yes, so that is what I said. Na? That's again a manual action. That is thinking, right? That is what is called thinking. Temporarily, it is like acting or all those things, right? Actors, if you see, they will, you know, it's not real. They will not express their real anger. But at that moment, whatever is their, you know, they're supposed to express, they will express their anger or happiness or whatever. So that may not be a real one. It may be induced or, you know, you are manually triggering it. Yes, that is temporarily, it's possible. So there is nothing wrong in it. No, as long as it is not creating a problem for you, there is nothing wrong. You don't have to brand anything as wrong and right. This is wrong and this is right. So the solution is required only when things are going out of hand, when you have a problem, right? When we say that, no, I'm stuck with sorrow, I'm not able to handle this sorrow, I'm not able to handle this anxiety, anger. When we say that I'm not able to handle these emotions and feelings, that is where everybody is stuck with. So that is when, you know, this, if you understand that these are not under our control, and if you simply allow everything to flow as is, then, you know, we don't have any role, we don't have to take any responsibility to correct them or arrange them in a proper way. That is all is needed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Thank you very much, Sanjay. I'm muting you. Good. Venkatesham from Nigeria is waiting. I'll give unmute. Yes, Venkatesham, you can talk now.
Good evening, Babulalaya and Anandaya.
Good evening.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Okay, yeah. As you were explaining to Mr. Sanjay, I was hearing everything. This is actually, you know, when we get a clear understanding, it's very so simple and reality. But the thing is that when I was hearing the Mr. Sanjay discussion with you, I got one point. So it's made me understand also something, because we always use the word that accept things as they are. So it's also applicable for us also. It is our inner state also. Whatever may be, we have to accept. That acceptance is our intellectual has to accept. That is the thing. Because what we are all talking is only intellectual level. So that our own intellect has to really understand that our inner state, that we cannot make any changes. As you told once sometime before, that apply these 4 points. Always and try and see. That is, which is not impossible, you know, by our hand. That, and as we are always, Aya Bhagavataya and as Anandaya, you all, everybody is mentioning that there is a natural flow. That the thing is that the natural flow No, we are trying to know itself. That means we try to recognize it. That means when we do try to recognize it, that means still our intellect is playing there. That we can't play game there, or we can't play there in our natural state, because it can express naturally. That is the one. Sometimes I get the feeling under the feeling. Yeah, is it true? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So that is fine. Accepting that you don't have any role to play in our psychological system. Yes, that is true. So only thing is, acceptance again is not an action here. Acceptance is that you don't have anything to do. So it is an inaction. You're coming to a conclusion. You have to come to a conclusion finally. Until you come to a conclusion, you can discuss, debate, you can, you know, try to see what is happening inside. You can try to experiment on your thoughts and emotions. All that is fine. That is absolutely fine. And finally, at one point of time, you have to come to a conclusion, whether it is in my control or not. Once you come to the conclusion, then you can, you know, once you understand your own, on your own self, that yes, it is not in my control. Once you accept that, then obviously you will not actually put any of your efforts again, right? Where you don't have any control, nobody will put their efforts. Only if you think that you have some role to play, you have some control there, then only you will try to change things. If you realize that you don't have any control, then you will stop all your efforts, because it's anyway going to be a waste of time. Even if you put whatever efforts, it's not going to change. So if you come to that realization, then you will not put any efforts. All your efforts will drop. Then you will not offer any resistance to the natural flow that is already in us, happening in us. So then naturally peace, silence, everything will come. It will settle on its own. It will come to a balanced state.
Correct, yeah.
Yeah.
And one more thing, when I was reading Aya book one time, suddenly what happened, that one changed my, make it me clear also. Tamil book, some book I read it. All our sensory perceptions are always in real manners, it is changing. It is no doubt on that. In reality, that every moment our sensory perceptions are in liberated state only. But I was thinking that I was never know that what is mind. So when I am also saying that mind also is in a liberating state already. That everything, it comes and goes, it comes and goes. That understanding made me really given a good understanding. So from there, a lot of other things are clearly I'm able to see and then understand it. Yeah. That is really beautiful. But the only thing is that the two words, inaction, action, actually inaction and action and surrender. Everybody actually, intellectually, we are able to, I think most of them in whoever is there in this discussion, most of them intellectually able to understand it very clearly. As an intellectual, we are all intellectuals, we are able to understand. The issue is that what is mean by real mean sense of surrender and the real sense of that means summa ira, that means inaction. That is where the core issue is there. But wherever I am, Tamil discussion, English, everywhere, the issue is that core issue is that surrender and inaction. That is where the core issue is there in us.
Yes.
So that is the point. Yeah. That is the point where everybody can understand and discuss. Yeah.
Yes, true. Very true. So basically surrender or inaction is not an action. It's an outcome of your understanding. When you come to that understanding, when you come to a point that I don't have any more control on this, right? So you will not act, right? When you really come to that conclusion after experimenting, doing all analysis, everything, when you come to that conclusion, when you don't have a role to play in a situation, then what will you do? You will simply have to be quiet. There is no choice. You don't have any choice. You will obviously drop your efforts. You will come to an inaction state and drop all your efforts. Then automatically the surrender happens. You cannot do surrender manually. You cannot say that I'm going to surrender, right? Surrender happens at that point of time. When you understand that you don't have any role to play, surrender and all these inaction, everything happens. So when it happens, then natural flow will automatically settle it.
Okay, yeah. Because when we use the word, because we always play with the word, game with the play, word. When we see the word surrender, it means there is something to be done from our part. Surrender means you are going to surrender something. That is where when we use the word, we always would, you know, everywhere, intellectually we study everywhere. So the surrender words actually coming is that we have to do something, surrender. But actually the surrender and inaction is combined both together. Yeah. Is a real sense. In a real sense, it's both together, combined together.
Yeah. True.
Uh, Okay, yeah, thank you. This is just you. I opened.
Yeah, it's a very good one. And then we thank Venkateshan for this. That is only the decision that is important. Words can be anything. It is automatically.
Yes, yes, true. Yeah, yes, yes, yes.
Correct. Okay, so I'm muting you. So next person who wants to have a discussion here or questions here, kindly raise your hands. Use your hands. Oh, Satya ji from Chennai, she has come.
Yeah. Raise hand is the option you have in the reactions. If you see in Zoom, there is a reaction button. There you have to press the raise hand option.
Okay.
Okay, can I speak?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. So I just see whether I've understood it properly. So the emotions, thoughts are not in our control. So there can be actions out of that also. Even that is not in our control. Out of that, again, an emotion and thought can come. Mm-hmm. So nothing is in our control, actually speaking.
Okay. Only one correction is actions. When you say action, suppose you're thinking about, a thought comes, I've not visited Bangalore, why don't I just go and visit sometime, right? If some thought comes like that, suddenly you're just watching a movie or something. So you will not act. I mean, you will not act without your control. Action is not, it's not going to happen without your control, right? You will have to plan, think, and do your external activity. So action is under your control. You can decide what to do and what not to do.
Okay.
So that is very much possible. Only thoughts and emotions are not under your
control. Not in my control.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, Satyaji. Mute. I'll mute. Okay. Anand Tirthan. Yes. Come unmute. And there also there will be an unmute signal will come. You have to use that. Yeah. Okay, done.
Yeah, good evening everyone. And I'm telling you. Fine. So what I understand is from this discussion, my thoughts and emotions are not in my control. I understand that very clearly. The thing is, I have some thought, I have some goal, okay, I want to reach it. How to make my mind, okay, work for me, okay, to support my actions, okay, not creating any resistance, okay, because I want to achieve something, but my mind usually comes in between and ruin the body, actually. Okay, how to make our mind support our goals or actions, that is my question. And one thing, what I found out is, from here, is in the past, in the very recent times, I'm experimenting with a lot of things. Whenever I see my mind as my friend, okay, he's not coming, he's not interrupting me to stop me or destroy me. It's not like that. It is trying to protect me. And I see him as a friend. There is a lot of what I can say. The mind is calming, and it is not giving me so much of trouble. Is it I'm going in the right way, or understanding my mind the right way? Okay, these are my thoughts popping up, and Anandana, I want to do.
Yeah. So the first part is how to make your mind support the external actions or the target that you want to achieve. So, see, mind, as we just explained, psychological system, which is all your thoughts, emotions. So, thoughts means all whatever thoughts appear, and emotions means it could be, as you said, an interest or passion, anger, anxiety. Everything is an emotion, right? So, these are all not under our control. Depending on the situation and depending on your nature, what are the conditioning you have, and all the various factors, it will produce some emotion, something. So, it is not under our control. So you cannot expect that I'm going to work on this and some emotion should be supportive to your action. So you don't have to expect that. So all you can do is, instead of focusing here, because our focus is always here, we are looking at what emotion comes now. Is this better? Is this positive or not? So we are more worried about what is happening here. So we should shift our focus from here to our actions. What is the action required? How best can I do this action? What are the various options possible? How can I take some suggestions from my seniors or other people? So our focus should be on how to do our action in the best way possible. If you focus, your focus here will automatically reduce, and automatically you will, it'll, you know, supporting emotions or supporting thoughts, etc. That you can, you yourself can see. But only thing is, whether it comes or not, it is not our botheration. Whatever happens here, we don't have to be bothered, because it is there. We don't have any role to play. Even if you are bothered, you cannot do anything here. That's the point of that we are trying to say. Even if you want to correct also, you will not be able to correct. That will be an endless battle here. So instead of focusing here, our energy here internally and trying to struggle with our emotions, our entire energy can be shifted towards the external action. Then actions will definitely be in a much better way, because all your energy is now going towards the external action. That will definitely be in a much better way. And the second part, I didn't get when you say you understood mind in a certain way. Yeah, what exactly?
Let me explain.
Yeah.
Because in a spirituality, no, everyone sees mind as a devil kind of thing. Okay. Mm. That is a thing which is stopping you from enjoying the life or experiencing the life. And when I go in that way, I find a lot of resistance in life. Okay. But whereas when I say the opposite view, okay, I don't see my mind as a villain. Okay. Instead of, I see as my friend who is trying to help me in his own way. Okay. When I change that perception of mind controlling me or stopping me is considerably reduced. I can experientially feel that. Okay, I can see the changes in me. Okay, so is that a right way to dealing with the mind?
Yeah. So what we are saying here is, because whatever you try to do with the mind, for example, when you try to make friendship with the mind, you'll not be able to do always, right? Sometimes then you will fail. Then again, that will become another torture, another problem. Then see, what we are saying is, whatever you try to do in the name of dealing with the mind, if you are start dealing with the mind, then that's where the problem starts. So you can give any name. You can give it, call it as meditation or any other positive thinking or whatever, making friendship, whatever name you give. If you finally trying to deal with your emotions, if you finally trying to change, you know, the way it is already working today, if you're not able to accept how it is today and trying to change things, that's where the problem starts. So in this, as per this concept, no, you don't have to do anything, and you cannot do also. That's the point, actually. Even if you try to do, you will not be able to. You can temporarily fine tune and do some things, that may be possible, but permanent solution, it is not possible. So permanent solution is accepting this whole thing as it is. Then the problem itself dies. Then there is no problem to solve. So we are only talking about an imaginary problem, thinking that you have to solve. That's the whole problem here.
Yes. This is what exactly I'm telling. What you're saying is, that is what I'm also saying, but in a different words. What I'm saying as a friend means I'm not objecting my mind. Okay. The emotions comes or a thoughts comes. When I only see it as it is opposite thing or it's a negative thing only, then only I try to change it. Okay. Mm-hmm. When it comes, I see as a friend, okay, I'm not fighting with my mind, okay. When it comes, okay, I take it, okay, I accept this. Accept is a word I need to use, but I haven't used it. Instead of accepting, I see it as, okay, it is trying to help me in its own way. Okay, I'm not bothering the mind and it is not stopped bothering me, okay. And this is what I've realized in the last few months. And the second thing is that what I felt is the feeling good, okay. The emotions, it also helping me. So something bad is happening or the situation is not favorable for me, okay? I'm dealing with some negative persons or the persons who are not aligned with me, okay? In that times, I try to change my emotions, okay, consciously, okay? And I try to be in a very good place. And it was also working practically. Is it the right way to deal with the people or a situation?
Yeah. So dealing with people and the situation externally by doing some actions, by taking corrective actions is fine. Because in the external world, you have to act. Nobody else can act on your behalf. Yeah. But trying to deal here with the emotions and thoughts is not needed, is what you're saying. Because it is like a waves in the ocean. It will arise and it is anyway going to die down in the next moment. The life of an emotion or a thought in reality, in its original state, is a very fraction of a second. Only because you try to control or you try to manipulate it, then it leaves again and again relives again and again and again. It feels, you know, you feel like this emotion is getting extended. It's for a long time. An anger or an anxiety is with me for a long time. I'm stuck with this anger. That's what we feel. Because we are trying to deal with that. If you stop dealing with it, it is going to die the next, very next moment. So you will not even realize that an anxiety has occurred here. So it is so such a fraction of a second, you know, all these emotions which come up, arise, subside, like waves in the ocean. So you don't have to deal with this thing at all. You are free. What we are saying is you don't have any responsibility. Just go and enjoy. You don't have to take this responsibility. It is already taken care. You don't have to take care of this system.
Awesome. Awesome answer. My final question. I understood the concept. Understanding the concept, I can assume what the answer will be, but I wanted to hear it from you.
Yeah.
The thing is, the goal setting, I want to create an habit. Okay. For an example, I want to wake up early in the morning. Okay. I know it is good for my future. Okay. How to create that habit?
Yeah. So this is again an external action, right? An external action of waking up, etc. So you will definitely have, see, mind is not going to support you, or you cannot expect that, you know, mind will always supply only positive emotions, positive thoughts and interest and all that. So that's what the point is. You focus your, if once your focus starts less on here, automatically your focus on your actions will increase. As you know, as far as the focus comes down to the psychological portion, the focus on the external world will increase. External activities will increase automatically because the energy level is 100%, right? If you reduce the energy here, slowly, if it becomes zero, then your 100% energy is available outside. So if you will start focusing on your external actions, you can, a lot of ideas will come up on your own. You know, you will think, you things like, for example, just for things like, you know, you will start forming a club or, you know, having a group of people, then you will, you know, automatically that will give you an interest or an energy to have a chit chat with them and also do your walking. Some these ideas automatically will come once you start focusing, fix the target and say that, okay, this is what I want to do. Be focused on the target rather than what emotion I'm getting, whether it is supporting my action or not. Don't focus on this here. Focus on the action is the...
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Anand. You are from Chennai?
Yes, I am from Chennai.
Okay. The light is very much insufficient. Your face looks dark.
Okay.
So, the light is at the back. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. So, thank you. Thank you very much for your participation. I am meeting you now. Venkateshan from Nigeria, you would like to discuss. Unmute.
When you are explaining to Anand Kirtanaya, as you said, one beautiful word you use. Actually, we use a word, but you use the word taken care. Our mind is already in a liberated state, it's already taken care. Like our body, because I started my life, all the things like this, I came to this Bhagavad Gita, it's because of my body. I started from body. Our body is highly intelligent. Nobody can deny that one. Each and everybody, whoever is realized that our body is highly intelligent. Definitely nobody can interfere our body intelligence. It is highly powerful, which I can use a word. Because nobody can deny it. I see it in my body. At the same way, as you said, it's taken care. That word inspired me, that you say that it is taken care. So whatever maybe it is taking care, no need to worry about that one, but it is already taking care. That is when I always feel in my, about my body as well as our mind also. Really, that another thing is that when he talks about how to use our mind as for our external activity, as you are also saying that when we don't fight with our mind, naturally, automatically all that of suggestions will come so that we can do activity. So when I hear your voice, two things I observed. The thing is that we actually last time also you repeated the same thing, that we try to fight with our internal state of mind, which is already natural, but we try to bring it to natural. That trying is our intellectual level, we try. So when we, that each and every action is energy, there is no doubt on that. Whatever may be, so external, whatever be. So that most of the time we try to saturate our mind, so all of our energy goes wasted there. So when we don't fight with that, all energy related to our body as well as to their external activity, definitely there is no doubt that it improves. There is no doubt on that. When we have to test it out, because testing is our part, there is no doubt. We cannot fight, we are not fighting out of our mind, but we can test it out related to our body, related to our mind. There is no doubt on that. It's very clear. Thank you.
Yes, yeah. You can test it out and you have to finally come to a conclusion. Yes, it is not under my control. Or if you feel, no, it is under my control, means you have to test it. So you have to come to a conclusion. Once you come to a conclusion, that's all. I don't have to tell you that, you know, don't waste your time, right? You will automatically stop wasting your time trying to control. That's all.
Yeah. The other one, the one question is that natural state. We always use the word natural state. When we are child, we are born. I also, in Tamil discussion, I also very clearly say that we are born in innocent state only. Okay. But we lose that innocent state, actually still existing with us. We lose it actually. So, but when we say that word, that innocent state, we know what we do actually intellectually. We try to get that innocent state. We try. But we try so many times in so many ways. But finally, we come to a conclusion that no way it is possible that we try to using our intellect. Because the intellect is also sustained by, which is a base, which is a real thing sustaining it. So when we realize and understand our inability of our intellect, but intellectually, there is no doubt that intellectually is needed in practical reality in the world, for external world. There is no doubt on that. So only thing we have to see really using our intellect, we have to really understand that what way the intellect can play role in an external world, what role can play in internal world, like we can use the word internal world, like I say Agampuram. So internal world, we cannot play any role with internal life. There is no doubt on that. I am very clear. So this whatever understanding I am sharing to you, I am.
Okay, thank
that
you.
Is no doubt on that. It's very, very clear. But the thing is that but matter is very clear. But the thing is that you know that I am also understanding that. I feel that it's wrong to ask question that that. Because you know we are born within the innocent state, but you know there is no how to test the innocent, our innocent state. But still I am asking that how could be the innocent state? You know, using our intellect only we are try to understand that. But how could be that? How our innocent state could be?
Yeah. So as you yourself said that innocent state is our natural state and it is there from our childhood. It is already there. So if something is not there, then I can tell you how to achieve. For example, if I say, or you are sitting in Nigeria, right? So you are already sitting in Nigeria. You cannot ask that, how do I reach? If you ask, how do I reach Nigeria? There is nothing, nothing is needed. You are already there is what is the answer, right? So same way, innocent state is already there. So, but you are only disturbing. So you are acting on it today. You are doing some action and disturbing that innocent state. So what do you have to do now? You have to rewind. I mean, what should I say? No, reverse effect. You are acting so far. Now you have to stop all your actions one by one. You have to unwind. There is no winding here. It is only the unwinding, enacting. You have to start all your actions. You have to stop all your actions, you know, slowly, one by one or whatever, whichever way. I'm just giving, just for example's sake, I'm saying you have to stop all your actions. The inaction is the thing required here. There is no action. But because of lack of words, when we say surrender or acceptance or whatever, people think that, you know, we have to do something there. No, it is only the understanding. We only have to understand this whole concept clearly. And we have to come to a conclusion that, yes, this is not under my control, these emotions and thoughts. Once you come to that, then you will automatically stop your actions. So this inaction is a state that should happen. You cannot arrive at that. You cannot try and make efforts and reach that state of innocence. Innocent state, or in other words, liberation, can only happen. You can only allow it to happen. That's all. Allowing it means here you should stop taking all actions. Because all the while from childhood, we are always used to taking actions and doing something. But here it is the reverse. You have to now stop taking all actions. You have to unwind slowly and sit back. That's all. Once you stop all your actions, that innocent state or liberation, which was already there anyway from your birth, it will continue. That's all. You are not getting anything. I mean, something new is not going to come in. It was already there. It was always there. So you'll only recognize when you stop all your actions. That's the whole.
Okay, yeah. I think when I hear your voice, that one thing you said, our innocence can easily can express itself in the external world. That is the thing I'm getting your speech, Aya. Is it true, Aya?
No, when you say easily expressed in the external world, means?
Because when you say that automatically, when you say that when we don't do a fight with our mind, a lot of things will come up and then give idea, and then when we concentrate on our job in external world, a lot of new ideas are related to success, like the word we use, the word success. Definitely, we need to do some success in the external world. So when we do external world success, so that kind of, we use the word I, also sometimes use the word I, intuitive idea, all the things. It naturally flow to us to do effectively in the external world. So when I can feel, I can take it as that it is coming from our innocent state, I am. It comes from the innocent state, I am.
Yeah, you can say it is coming from your nature or whatever. So the point is, when you try to focus, earlier we were focusing 80% here and 20% there. Now you're putting all focus, 100% focus there. Then obviously, which means you are giving your entire time. So obviously, a lot of ideas, the additional ideas, additional thoughts and some other things will definitely come. Na? Because you're focused more on that. You're giving more time to that. So obviously, a lot of things will come for your support. It will help you in your actions.
Okay, yeah. Then one thing I want to, maybe other people are not asking about, maybe somebody is there. The one thing is about karma. See, actually, when I was not aware about all the things about this our psychological world, I never know what is mean by psychology, anything. I was never know about how this body itself is functioning. So now I wonder that what is that brought me to here? That to make this giving, understand all the things. When we go to spiritual, all the things that they call synchronicity. We use the word, actually still it is a word, yeah. But to make the synchronicity to take place, that is happen, something will guide us, something will help us. Also, in spirituality, everywhere when we go, everybody started telling that we stay synchronicity. It happened. Is it related to our karma? Yeah? Is that karma play a role to come this kind of this thing in understanding all the things? Yeah?
No. So karma, yes. I mean, it is more related to external action, first of all. And synchronicity, when you say, I think you're talking about body, mind, working in a harmonious way or something like that, right? So that is required for your external actions. All this is fine for your external actions. You can form some ideas, form some philosophy, create some method, whatever you want to use, even meditation, whatever it is, you can use it for your external action. That is very much fine. That is up to you. It is your decision, your choice. But here we don't have any choice. This is what we need to understand first. Here, once you close this topic once for all here, then whatever is available to you in the external world, it is completely up to your choice. So only thing you have to realize is you don't have any control here. That is the only point. External world is your completely your choice, right? So if you act in the right way according to the society, the dharma and all that, then it will bring you all results as you require.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Venkatesan. Now, Dr. Prem Kumar is waiting, but it is not visible here. He has sent a message.
Okay.
Prem Kumar, I'll give you unmute. Oh. Prem Kumar, you are getting? Good. Got it.
Yeah. Sir, good evening, Hi. Sir.
Yeah, good evening. Carry on.
Yes, sir. I'm just trying with my laptop. There's some problem.
Your voice is disconnected. Getting disconnected.
I'm not able to get.
It's not continuous. You put off your video, then you talk, please.
Yeah, fine. Hello, can you get, sir?
No, you switch off your video because your bandwidth is giving.
I switched off, sir.
Okay. Please, you talk now.
Yeah. Can you hear, sir, now? Am I?
Yeah, you speak. 2-3 words is not sufficient. This is okay. Please continue. I think it is problem at its end.
Hmm.
He's not getting. Anyway, Narayan from Chennai is waiting. Now, I'll give unmute to Narayanji. Yes.
Yes. Good evening, Bhavnath sir.
Good evening, sir. Please come.
Good evening, sir. Yeah. So I had the same thing. I think you've explained to Mr. Vengadesh, but then still I just want to reiterate the same thing. So when I'm trying to do the external thing, now it is clear internal we cannot do anything.
Yeah.
But when we are doing the external thing, and if we are not able to succeed in that external thing, or we have some struggle with the external work, that also creates some ripple inside, right? So what is happening, unless until we are not clear with this external action, still that cripple is there inside. It's keep on sounding from inside that you are not capable or you are not able to do it. Something is coming. Mm. So that's what I just want to ask on that. So,
yeah. So cripple means you're talking about some voice or some
yes.
kind of chattering. So chattering, you cannot stop, or you don't have to worry about it, because that's again another thought or emotion. You can leave it and focus on your work. But if it is related to your external activity, sometimes it might give you some ideas also, right? Like you said, you know, maybe I'm not capable. It means you can really see whether you can use that and see, okay, really, am I capable? You know, you can test it out, right? Am I capable? Can I really do these things? Am I doing it, compared to others? Am I doing it in a better way? Can I learn? Can I do it in a, you know, different way? Can I do it this action in a much better way? In different forms, whatever actions you want to take, you can try all that, because you don't have to, if it is related to your external actions, if it is useful, you know, whatever the chatter or thought which comes, if it is useful to correct your external actions, to make your external actions in a better way.
Okay.
You can definitely use that. There is nothing wrong in it. And probably most of the times it is coming only for that purpose. It is coming only to push you and trying to, you know, push you to see alternate options, you know, to look at better options or to do your actions in a better way. That is why it is coming primarily. So you can look at all those possibilities and scope available in the external actions and do that. If you don't have any scope, then just forget it. I mean, this is how mind will react. Just simply ignore.
Mm-hmm. Got it. So, thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Anybody else? Prem has come or what? Anybody else who wants to have a discussion or question, please raise your hand. Raghunath, I'm giving unmute. Raghunath from Qatar, I'm not sure.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. Good evening, both of you, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir. Raghunath from Qatar.
I'm right.
Sir, my question is actually same like... that external actions. If I assume that I have an organization and I invested some major to do some best services, in that one I given some president, secretaries, like that, some positions are there. And in that one, both are in that two teams are fighting and they are not doing any good job there for that organization. So now I want to remove it. Actually, my duty is to give society and come out, to do service and come out, to construct some things, to hand over to and come out. Now the situation is both are fighting, means I have to remove them. No way, actually, because my condition is not fulfilled externally. I have to remove both of them and I have to hand over to find out someone new one to give to run that society in a good way. Here my question is actually, When I want remove, they are not 100% did nothing, but they did also initially little bit good, and but for service oriented 100% effort and all, they are not taking. So my question is here, once to wanted to remove, that time my mind, inner mind is saying, okay, they did something, I do not want to hurt anything, let them go, let them leave it, but the real output is not there and no action, both conflict was there. So one way I have to remove completely, the other way mind is saying that it will hurt them, so leave for some more time, like that. So that background mind is I am trying to stop it, but still it's induces and forcing me to not take action. In this case, how would we take, sir? Just for suggestion.
Yeah, sure. See, actually, that removing some, you know, them, you're treating it as an as a main action, and you know, not removing is some background actions. Actually, both are mind. Mind is, that is the function of mind, right? Whenever you're in a situation, mind will give you 3-4 options or 5 options, whatever is in the scope or whatever is the situation related to that. Mind will give you all options. So this is our intellect. We have to decide and choose which is the right option. So nobody can, you know, give a formula for that, because it is depending on the situation. It is depending on your situation, your capability, and so many factors are involved, right? So based on that, you can choose one of the options. That is the job of your intellect. So if mind will keep on supplying all these options, that's the role of the mind. If mind stops giving all options, then it will not work, right? You will not have, and mind is probably pushing you. When you said initially you might have decided that you might remove them, but mind is pushing you to consider alternatives also. That is why another thought is coming. That's the job of the mind. It will give you all sorts of options. Then you have to weigh the pros and cons. What is positive here? What is positive? What is negative here? Weigh all the positives and negatives or all the options and conclude, decide that which is better. That's your decision. So there is nothing, nobody can say anything, you know, because that is completely under your decision and your control.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So that means I decided to remove them and make it. So it is not, see, I'm not going to rule it. Actually, I'm going to summon it who is going to do better that one. So it should not be abstract like that. So I decided to remove means, even though they can come and do service, whatever they can do it, still they're in their role or as a volunteer, they can do it. But they leave the chance to others. I decided, okay, now what you're saying, you know, that inner mind saying, so I ignore it actually. So I don't need to think that karma, it will affect my karma again. I'm doing some mistakes. It will add to my like that and all some other parallel going. I can ignore it. I understand from you.
Yeah. So karma is more of the intention or the motive also, right? For example, if you're a policeman or taking up some job where you have to be rough or you have to treat with people in a rough manner, then you have to do that, right? That's your duty. So if you are in that role, then you have to do what is correct for that role. So that is what it means. That's all. But you have to decide. Sometimes, you know, you may not have, you know, yes and no, a black and white of 1-0 may not be there. Situation, you know, will be like, it'll be gray. There will be some gray area. This may not be, it may not be an yes no situation. It may be something in between. So all that will be there. That's the complexity we have in the external world. That we have to use our intelligence and use the best possible option. That's all. I mean, nobody can say that you will always make the perfect best decision only. You know, nobody can claim that. You know, all big, even big people have failed in their decisions or made some bad decisions. Nothing wrong in that. So you have to learn. If you made a wrong decision once, you have to learn and take that lesson and maybe make it, do it better the next time. That's all we can do. We have to keep on doing that only.
Okay, sir. Good. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yeah. Sir, now just one more few tips like that. What I would like to get from information from you, like understanding and thoughts and thinking, and the other puram, agampuram. Is it the all three, or it is one, or it says one, or it is this will be giving more understanding, this will be giving more, this will be more. So in that one, any three points if you interlinked, I need actually. See,
okay.
Sometimes it is good. Understanding means I understand that thoughts will continuously come. In that one, what you said now, that pick up something which is good and we do that one. So pick up is our point, and other thing, whatever it goes, we need to ignore it. And second time, and another thing. So thoughts are thinking means actually the what is same thing. Thoughts will be continuously, it will come many things, and we need anything in that one we take for action, which thinking we'll take it like that. And the third and the agampuram means actually, so there is no further inner chatting or inner do deal with it. So ignore it and go like that. So in that one, so sometimes we get again attached where it is happening, no? Okay, I understand that free time at home or anything, and okay, when I go out office, if I work at my job, it is my computer job. I keep on doing my that mail correspondence and other duties. In that one, some default because once you start some jobs, we know that what is the real reply we want to do. So in that way, what will happen by default, it will go. Default, I will it will answer will go. But the background unnecessarily that again consuming something. Then when I come home and say, so what happened? We are not 100% conscious into our job. We are trying to conscious, but still the old habit it is taking that. It is talking to that inner also. Some percentage is taking. How to overcome that?
Yeah. So you are probably trying to be. You are consciously trying to check whether I am concentrating or focusing on my external job or not. So, because you are again trying to check whether my mind is functioning correctly or not. That's what indirectly it means. Whether it is focusing on this or it is giving some other chatter. You don't have to focus here because we don't have any role to play. Even if you focus and try to do something, you cannot deal with the system. This is not our responsibility. You don't have to play any role here. All you have to focus is only your external action. Whatever chatter happens, whether confusion comes, background voice comes, whatever name you give, it is all finally thoughts and emotions, right? You're just giving all these are different names. That's all. Finally, it is a thought emotion. Yeah, thought or emotion. That's all. Feeling, whatever is happening here inside into your system. That is the role of the mind. You can simply, that is what we are saying, that you don't have any role here. You don't have to try and change this here. Rather, focus our energy on trying to work in the external activities. That's all we need to focus.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Another thing, actually, when analyzing like that and all, where that the thoughts are even the me without before consciously awareness that thoughts it is it went to thinking sometimes. You understand my point? So the thoughts. Yeah. So I want to differentiate the thoughts and thinking in that each of my things. Why I want to see thoughts, let it separate it and go. That one that I don't want to make it thinking like that. When we do like that, sometimes the thoughts and thinking together, without very fast, it is having very fraction of a second. No? So it will, by previous many things, many input comes, like example, suppose some suggestion coming, somebody from external asking doubt or from related to job or anything to personal job, only through hearing and by seeing something you are more outside, that the input coming from hearing only coming. So then our action is going by mistake or consciously or unconsciously by mouth. So we are talking something consciously, it is true, but some we are trying to make it okay. We want to limit it to this much only. We don't want to talk like more and we want to rest less like that and all. We are trying in that way. Is it true like that? We wanted to have that awareness. It will be like that only. I mean, what I'm to say is, okay, when I want to talk, I want to talk the real conversation, real information I want to process. So that time also, what will happen, my unconsciously, the background will come, it will tell more and it will, by habitual, it will go fast. So I want to be very cautious now. I'm thinking that one. In that way, when I analyze, it is showing the thoughts and thinking also sometimes with unnecessary thinking also going fast.
Yeah. So this thought and thinking, first of all, is only to make you understand. It is only an analysis. We are trying to analyze how our mind functions. That's all. In real-time situation, you will not be thinking about, is this thought or am I thinking now? Should I switch off my thought and get into thinking? Should I switch off my thinking and is it thought? You don't have to get into all this confusion. It is only for understanding. We are only separate whatever is happening on its own. Even that thinking, if it happens on its own, that is fine. Consider them as thoughts. So whatever is happening on its own, you don't have any role to play because it's anyway happening on its own. You don't have to take responsibility for what is happening. That is what we are saying. That's all. You can put all that as thoughts also. Whatever is, even if you think unconsciously without your knowledge, consider that also as thoughts. That's fine. Only when you come to your senses, when you come to your knowledge, obviously you will know that you are thinking about something which is not needed, right? At that time, you can stop. If you're not able to stop, consider that as thoughts also. You don't have to, it is not about, you don't have to do a strict, bifurcation between what is thought and thinking in reality when you are actually in a situation. when you are in an external situation, when you are acting in a situation, your focus only should be on the situation. What is the target? What is the result you want to achieve in that situation? What is the objective of that situation? You should only think about that. All these internal things, let it happen. You don't have to even bother about that. That we don't have any control anyway.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. Thank you. Which opportunities and I missed because of this inner chatting. Now I can overcome by taking that and retaking that challenges. I can do something like whatever I missed it. What will happen now? So there are some molded thoughts and actions innerly molded thoughts which used to come and stop my external actions. So whatever it is already molded and it is okay. So example, it is guilty or it is unfulfilled desires. Like some actions did wrong in the past and all. So whatever the past, only few things which I missed it and which I did wrong, and these things only it is repeating now, nothing more. And which is going to take now new. In that new, some action I have to take. Positive negative will come. In that one I have to concentrate. So what I understand now, that means background molded, whatever the cases, whatever thing happened. Past, if it is comes, I have to ignore it. Now go forward, start new life, and focus only on external things, and make it schedule and do it correctly. And so it will be helpful. I feel it. Am I right?
Yeah. So focus, shift the focus from looking at what is happening here. Am I correct here? Is this perfect? Is this system functioning perfectly well? Our focus is always here. You're looking at here rather than focusing here. Look at focus. Shift the focus there. Is my activity working well? Am I doing my activity in a right way? How can I do it better? How can I do actions in a better way? So focus, shift your focus there, because this anyway, there is no point. Even if you focus, you will keep on struggling. That's all, because you don't have any role here. Whatever happens, let it chatter, let it complain, let it give all your worries, thoughts, your molded, unfulfilled desires, whatever. As I just mentioned to somebody else, whatever, all these are different names. Finally, it is another thought, another emotion. That's all, right? So that is what is the function of mind. That is the role of mind. It will keep on making some noise. You don't have to worry about it. You can simply shift your focus here, because you don't have any role here. Even if you try to take this under control, it is not going to come under your control. So we don't have any choice. Instead of struggling here, focus your energy there.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now, yeah. So if I wanted to make it some disciplined way in our my personality also, suppose if before and now when we talk now, suddenly any mistake or somebody did, we used to comment it actually. Now I feel it actually, it is giving a relationship, that is the one, it is cutting the relationship. Now even though we wanted to avoid that one, like that I'm thinking, wanted to more conscious, actually it will not help also. So in that way, some actions, these things will concentrate, and it has to reduce and make it more personality development. I felt it. So thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Raghunath. Meeting you now. Prem Kumar from Chidambaram. I think he tried and disconnected because of the net problem. Good evening, Anuj. Yeah, Prem.
Good evening, sir. There was some network issue.
Good evening, sir.
Actually, sir, right now, after this kind of knowledge by the Bhagavataya, I was totally changed. I can see the sense how I was before and how I am seeing now. The same situation used to come before, and now I'm able to see how I reacted that time, how now I'm reacting. I can able to differentiate it properly, but I'm still facing some issues. So in that way, I want to ask you a question. First question is a fear. If I'm trying to do something new, I used to get fear and I get back from that new work.
Yes, yeah, continue.
The question is the fear. I used to have fear to do some new works, which I don't have any knowledge.
Yeah.
but I have to do. If I want to grow in my career, I have to do that. No option for me. Okay. But this fear not allow me to do that work. So how I can overcome that, and what is the psychology over there, or what is the, what I can do for that?
So you don't want to have this fear, is it?
No, actually, I want to do the work. I want to do that work. That's all. Fear coming, it is a struggle for me now, I feel.
Yeah. So I think I remember, I don't know whether it was you or somebody else. Well, for the thing, it was a similar question. So fear is also, it is not that fear is always bad, right? Fear is also, it's trying to only hint you that, you know, something may fail, or whatever you are going towards a target, it may not work. It is only giving you another opportunity, an alternate possibility. Because everything, whatever you do may not be always successful. There may be situations where you have to face some failure, or it may not happen according to your expectations. So fear is only trying to hint that possibility, right? If you go blindly that, you know, everything is going to be successful, I'm always going to be 100% successful, then you may not take care of the alternate options, the backup options, or, you know, alternate possibilities. You will not consider the alternate possibilities of failure, and you will not plan for that, right? So fear is something which is coming to help you in that way, that if fear comes that you're planning to do an activity, fear says, you know, no, this activity, you may fail. Then you can see, okay, what are the possibilities of failure? You know, these 1, 2, 3 possibilities. Okay, how do I take care of these possibilities? What should I do to make sure that, you know, this will not be a failure? What are the things I can do to take care as a backup possibility? So it is coming to help you only. So you have to take care of that in the external action. But fear as an emotion, you don't have a say whether it should come or not come. We don't have any say, right? Because that is where we are saying we don't have a control. If you start fighting with it, then that, you know, fear should not be there. If you start fighting with that, then that is where the problem starts. That is where the conflict and the struggle starts, and you will keep on be struggling, an endless struggle here inside. You will not be able to focus on your activity there.
So my second question is, sir, we focus on one goal and we are working over there, we are full focused and there is no deviation, anything, we are going good on that. After some point it gets saturated, we can't go beyond that goal on that time. By physically also we are not ready to do that work. At that point, we need to complete that, but we can't be able to do. So in that point, we get disturbed, basically. We are not following the inner voice, but in that case, it is collapsed, all the things.
So that is again in the external action, you have to take whatever is the right action. You cannot be always perfect, right? Nobody is 100%
perfect.
You cannot be 100% winning, successful all the time. Sometimes you will fail. Sometimes you will succeed. So all these things are possibility, right? So when you fail, you have to learn the lesson, take that lesson and see how do you act better in the next time. That's all possible. In the action, external world, only that is possible. The internal world...
Last 1 week, I was failing in my task. So it means I'm overdoing the work, or it's my nature, I don't know. I have keep some task on doing that, but I could not complete. Always I used to fail in that task.
So last 1 week for, I used to fail. That could be for various reasons, but one thing you have to, one basic thing is probably you can focus more, and you know, if you give importance to that activity, obviously you will you will give all your energy to that, right? Suppose, for example, now you're just you know, casually sitting and talking to me. Suppose somebody, one of your friend or some colleague nearby, suppose he is falling unconscious, right? You will stop, disconnect everything, and you will attend to that, because that is the most critical thing now you have to attend to, right? You will take him to the hospital, do what? You give your full attention there. All these conference calls or exam. Tomorrow you may be having an exam also. You may, you know, you may have to, you will postpone for some time. You will attend to that first. Because that is what feel is critical at this point of time. You are giving the utmost importance to that activity, to that incident that happened. So similarly, whatever activity that you're involved in, if you're giving utmost importance, if you feel that this is the most important activity for me, you know, that I have to work on this, then obviously your energy, attention, focus, everything will go towards that. So okay. That is the, you have to give your importance. You have to come to a conclusion and give importance to that activity. Then automatically your emotions, your focus, everything will shift towards that.
Okay, sir. I understand this point. So I just want to tell my situation now. Hmm. Actually, I'm living in the home. Hmm. When I try to concentrate on my complete work, my family members used to take my times. They used to tell, go here, do that work, go for markets and this kind of things. Me back to complete my task. So I was disturbed in this way also, that we can't deny. So anyway, we have to go on that way. There is no option, right, sir?
Yeah, yeah. External world, see, it's an artificial arrangement. We have all agreed for an arrangement, right? There is no, there is nobody who is coming and giving some instructions there. We have only agreed for our own convenience. So external world, there will be complications, there will be injustice, there will be, you may have to fight with somebody. So all those things will be there. So that depending on your capacity, your knowledge, you have to try and sort it out in the best possible way. You can take advice from your seniors or other friends also. External world, we have to manage. There is no one single formula that you can, which will solve all your external world.
It's only for internal only.
Yeah, internal. Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, sir. My last and final question, because it is getting very late, I will complete very soon. The last question is like, when someone used to scold on me, I used to get bad or feeling down. And one more point over here is, some people are used to tell about others in a wrong way. That is automatically registered on my mind. Mm-hmm. And when I think about that people, that negative thought about the people used to come on my mind. Mm-hmm. So is it correct?
Yeah, I mean, correct means I can see all these again, it's a thought. When you are meeting that person, all this comes on it automatically, right? You're not trying to say that I have to think this now, right? So it happens on its own. That is natural. That is how it will be. Don't worry about all that. Our focus should be, what is the activity that you want to do with that person? Your focus should be on that target or the result that you want to achieve out of meeting that person. So then automatically things will fall into place.
Okay. Whatever may be the negative thought, doesn't, we should never consider, and we have to focus on the external thing which is right now needed. Am I, sir? Am I right?
Yeah. Never consider in the sense, I think you must have heard the initial conversations. It is not an action. Yes. It is an understanding that we don't have any role here. If you try to change something here, that will be an endless struggle. You will be in a continuous conflict with this internal system.
Okay.
That's the problem.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So I'm muting you now. Sudhish from Lucknow is there. I'm giving unmute. Sudhish ji, you can talk now.
Hello, sir. Good evening.
Yeah, hi, sir.
Bablo ji, good evening.
Yeah, good evening, sir. Good evening. Acha.
The thing is, earlier, we were said that we had to work hard for getting enlightenment or liberty. But now we came to know we need not to do anything. It's just as simple. You have to sit. You need not to do anything. It is in us with us, the enlightenment. The liberty. Okay, there is nothing to do with it. When we come to external, now some people say you have to work hard. Is there some way that we need not to do anything in there also, in external also? We need not to work hard. We need not to do think hard about it. That's the thing I want to know.
I don't think there is anything easy in the external world, right? Because you have to for tomorrow, your food and shelter, clothing, everything, you have to work for your own. Nobody is going to work and give you free. So in the external world, everything you have to work for your own. If you want something, you have to work. Nobody is going to give you free, right?
Will some idea come after some while and say you need not to do anything? Now we have a cassette, it seems. We have a book like Secret. Mm-hmm. They say you need not to do anything. You just sit simply and think of it, and it will come. It will become true.
Yeah, that's what. In the external actions, it is not going to, right? If you keep on thinking that I want lunch today and all, it's not going to happen, right? Only you have to act. If you're hungry, then you have to cook, or you have to go and get meals from outside somewhere. So So you have to take some actions. Then only you can, the external world, you have to act, right? Without that, things are not going to happen on its own.
Yeah. Action is necessary. Working hard.
Yeah, that is,
we have to put, you say, effort. Either we are telling.
Okay, fine. Got it. So that is up to your, it is completely up to you. No? It is your choice. When you say working hard is again a relative term. Nobody can say working hard is, you know, working for 8 hours or 5 hours or 16 hours. Everybody will have their own terminologies, their own interpretations. Suppose if somebody is interested, say, for example, people are in, you know, music or acting. So they may, it may be very passionate about that. Even if they want, if somebody is asking them to do 24 hours, they'll be happy about it. Right. So it is not about the, it's only a relative term, working hard. So whatever you think is reasonable for you, for your living environment, your lifestyle, your situation, financial situation, everything, for your surrounding, whatever is best reasonable, you can do that. If you think something is unreasonable, it is your choice only. You can reduce, you know, you can reduce your time spending on that work, or you can take up an alternative work, which is easier. That is completely up to our choice. Nobody can, you know, suggest something on your behalf, right? Whatever is you think is the up to you. That is completely up to you.
No other option.
I'm saying it is completely up to you. You have the choice. It's not no other option.
No. For nothing other than hard work brings success like that.
No, again, you're talking about a relative term, right? Success means you cannot say earning 100 crore is success, right? Somebody might be okay with 10 lakhs also. I'm fine. Tomorrow, if I get 10 lakhs, that's all. I'm going to stop all hard work. Somebody might feel that. It depends on what they want to achieve, or, you know, their financial situation and so many other factors, external situations.
See, in enlightenment is the ultimate goal for, not enlightenment, liberty is the ultimate goal in spirituality.
Yeah.
So for that, once we were working hard, we were said you have to do sadhana, you have to do that one, you have to do meditate, you have to wake up early in Amrita Vela, you have to wake up, you have to think of God every time. And that was the thing, it was set for us earlier.
Yeah.
The same thing is in an outer world also. You said if you want a success, you have to work hard, you have to do something like that. Here now Aya came to us and said that internal, it's nothing to do with within you. You have nothing to do. In external also, there are some people saying just thinking is enough. Nothing other than thinking is enough. It will be done automatically. It will be done by the external force. Something will help you, or it will make it happen. There possibilities?
Okay, so that's what, as I said, the external world, without that, it is not possible. But you can, if it is related to your external world, if it is going to help you in some way, you can try it out. There is nothing wrong in it. You can try, if somebody is saying that without acting, the external actions will be taken care, you can try that. No, there is nothing, no harm in it. You can see how it works. What is the philosophy behind that? You can try to do some research on that. That's not a, and see how it works. And if it works, then you can tell others also, of course. But we'll see how it works for us.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sudhish. I'm muting you now.
Okay.
Anybody else who wants to have a question or discussion here? Kindly use hands raise option. Narayan Chennai. Unmute.
Hello, sir. Me again.
Yeah, please.
So going through the conversation, like for most of us, it is clear that now people have shifted from internal to external. So now the discussion is like kind of like how to overcome the external things. Is there any magical aspect is there, or is some other aspect is there? So what I could understand from here is that there is no other magical option, or nothing is there. So to our living, we have to do something in the external to achieve it. And out of doing that, if we get something affected internally, that also we have to ignore and we have to find out the alternative way, and we should not again fight with our internal thoughts. That is what you are saying, right, sir?
Yeah, okay. You don't have to fight means you don't even have to watch whether it is disturbing or not, whether it is creating disturbing thoughts or not. You don't even have that role to watch continuously. Is this correct? Is this perfect? Am I keeping it right? You don't even have that role. Simply close this whole chapter of internal at all.
Got it.
Forget that you have something called mind also. You don't have to worry about it.
Fine.
Simply act. That's all.
Got it. So if you are currently, if you are struggling with what we are doing, then you are suggesting that you try to find out an alternative thing which is somewhat comfortable for you to work, or something it is okay for you. So don't need...
That is in the external situation. That is up to your choice.
Correct. So don't bring that internally and again start from the beginning. That's what you're saying, right, sir?
Sort of. I mean, it is not internal though, but you're only trying to check. It is hard work or whatever you want to do. It is completely your choice.
Depending
on the dharma and the society rules and regulations, you can do anything within that limit.
Got it, sir. Thanks. So one thing is very clear. So for the external work, we don't have any magical ways.
We
have to. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm meeting you now. Yes. Raghunath from Qatar. Unmute.
Okay. Sir, good evening. Actually, during my conversation, I asked one question that differentiate between that three actually, like understanding or revelation to get it, that one, that thoughts, thinking and agampuram, all three same like that. I asked one. I answered you.
I can clarify. So all these are various points of view, and finally the core, it is only pointing to the final, the core truth or the concept. The main subject of this concept is psychologically, these thoughts, emotions, feelings, whatever is happening inside is not under our control. If you try to take responsibility to correct this, you will only be in an endless struggle, because something that is not under control and you are trying to do something means it's not going to work. It's not going to listen to you. You will be always in struggle. So there will be an endless struggle happening here. So you will, that is the problem. So to come out of this problem, the solution is you don't have to do anything. If you understand, you have to come to that understanding. So all these thought, thinking, agampuram, and all these are only trying to make you conclude this point. So all your actions, your energy and your focus, intelligence should be only the external actions. That's all. It's only giving different points of view. That's all. In agampuram, you're saying this is internal. You don't have to focus here. Focus your energy in the outside world. That's what it's saying, agampuram. Thought and thinking is whatever happens on its own is consider them as thoughts and ignore. That is what again we are saying. Thinking is required for your external actions. You can do it, whatever is required for your external action. So liberation, enlightenment is, I think you already know, because liberation is something which is then happening. It's an outcome of your understanding. Understanding is what we call as enlightenment. Understanding that we don't have any role to play here. Concluding that, coming to that understanding is the enlightenment. So finally, all these things are referring to the same point only.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Can I ask one more question? In my mind, that is, udalile noi ullathile kalangam is called pavathin ariguri, like that. What is this? Whatever internally we have is like agitation. It was like a sin before, past sin, like that. Some jnanis, something told. It was in my mind. Now I am removing that, and so it is not like that. Now I am understanding. Am I right?
Correct. You can take it that way. Yes. Because internally everything is correct. There is nothing wrong, no sin, no virtue, nothing positive, nothing negative internally, no positive, negative, nothing. Everything is same. Internally, everything is one and the same. You can give a complete pass mark or tick mark for everything internally. Only in the external world you can manage.
Very good. So thank you. One more question. So whatever we did in the past mistake, that means internally instead of struggling, what remedy, what things to be done for that? If it is like if I did mistake to the anybody, I can ask them to meet sorry or anything, or if anything I anything to be returned to them by personally or anything, we can do it. That's all. So like that, anything possible, we'll do it and forget. Collect.
Correct. Exactly. Okay. If there is a scope for remediation, scope for correction, you can do it. If there is no scope, then the incident is already over. Then you cannot do anything. Just take the lesson that next time I can be more careful. That's all.
Okay. So in that way, thank you, sir. In that way, one more also it will go. Okay. Some they said whatever the cause and effect, they said in some other things I learned like that. Cause and effect. Whatever sales is whatever you did in the past or something thing, you have to get it. So in that way, future, whatever it comes, we leave it to them. We don't need to think that okay, we did mistake and guilty or something is going to come. It's going to affect family or this and all. Now we realized it actually okay, it's happened that one by ignorance or by unconsciously by thoughts and our action. So we can leave it as it is and now we will avoid it and go forward like that. Am I right?
Correct. Yeah. Whatever happened has already happened. We can look forward how to do things correctly. That's all.
Thanks, sir. Thanks, sir. Great, sir. Sir, Babulal sir used to put your, if you put your number on that last, it will be good for us to make us record and if record to talk, sir. Please.
Sure.
Whose number? Anandji number.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let me see. Oh, fortunately, it is readily available.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Now I'll note down, sir. 1 minute, sir. I'll take screenshot. 1 minute, 1 minute. Okay, sir. Done. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you very
much. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you for both, sir. Babulal, sir, how you are very calm and how you are doing like that. One question for you, sir. How patient it came to you because is it... you are dedicating time and doing very patience. So please tell your experience, sir. How long you are here and how it happened. So it is motivating for all. See, when I see anybody that are all there clearing our doubts and all are in the same path and it seems you are also same. So please share your experience.
I'll tell it in a very short way. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I first met Aya in 2013.
Okay.
The first camp.
Okay.
Okay. So before that, I was little difficult fellow to access. Okay.
Okay.
So even in the house also, they used to recognize in a different names. Yamtan, Magan, something like that. Okay.
Eh? Okay.
There's a movie there. In that movie, that character comes. So. So it was like that. Then Aya gave me a work that daily you post something. So I started doing from 2016 onwards.
Okay.
From that day onwards, daily it is coming up. So what happens that by posting in a single posting, you know, I have to read 3 times.
Okay.
So I started realizing it automatically it has dissolved the things. I have not done anything.
Okay.
I have not planned. Okay. I have not planned and done anything. Okay. It has done by itself by going through, by just passing through the stream.
Okay.
You need not plan. You need not do some effect. You need not do any exercise. Only thing what I did was I was in the stream.
Okay.
So now thoroughly I have got changed. So there is a lot of change in my characters like I don't get easily angry. I listen people. All those things happen. Not that I'm not getting angry. I do get angry. Okay. But it is less now relatively. This is what it is. So
thank
whether
you,
it is
sir.
Enlightenment, liberation, they're all different. But I feel the difference and people feel the difference. And 2 days back, my wife was called here for comment and then she was telling about his anger have got vanished.
Thank you, sir. I got your patience. So, see, because I'm also 1 month watching, you know, during this time. Then I realized, okay, see, automatically it's coming to my picture, my thoughts. Okay, oh, see, going good, wow, how good, like that. So, thanks, sir. Thanks,
okay, sir. Okay. By just going through this this thing, you know, you will automatically, it will take place by itself. You are not, I have not done anything. It has done by itself.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you for
that. That is, sir. Where I am not able to give any further explanation. It has done by
itself. No, I understand. You covered everything. Thank you, sir. Thank you. This talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Anivar Requirement. Anybody else have got a question? During the first meeting, Sudhish has, okay, anyway, I'll just freeze the sentence. Yeah. During the first meeting, it was 2013 in August, when Aya spoke for 30 minutes, we spoke for 2 hours, asking so much of questions. Then, within, say, a matter of couple of months, no, it has fully died. Now there is no question at all. Okay? Sudhish, I'm unmuting you.
Hello. Yeah. So the role of ego in internal, can you say, because we are facing daily, we are facing people. Continuously, we have to face the same people. When we face the same people, our ego gets hurt. To handle it?
So internally, I mean, whatever ego is, again, part of, it's just an identity or the feeling of I, right? I, again, is also part of a thought that is also in a flow, in a state of flow only. You don't have to worry about it. There's nothing permanent here. Internally, whether it is there or not, we don't have to worry. Externally, it is required. It is an identity, right? If you have to achieve, if you want to act in the external world, you will need that identity of separate self. Then only you will act. Right, then only you will act and work towards your benefits or your targets or in your favor, etc. So the external world is sometimes needed also, but sometimes if it is unjustified, if it is not required, that you can take a call, because it is an action. External world, you have the choice completely. Whatever you want to do, you can do in the external world. Only thing is, don't worry about the emotional thing. Whatever emotions come, whether it is whether you call it as ego or whatever it is, the emotions, you don't have to worry about it. Don't focus here. Focus on the external actions, and you can. It is completely up to your choice. We don't have to worry about this, whether it is ego or not. We don't have to think about all that.
But intellectually, we know. Uh-huh. But it doesn't happen. We know we should not react. There's nothing to do internally. But when we continuously see them or continuously interact with them, when we continuously work with them, it again and again it comes, again and again it indicates.
Yeah, so let it indicate. The problem point is, in the external world, what is the right action to do? Like, you don't have to depend on, see, just because, for example, if you are working in a firm, You don't have to say that just because you are the manager or you are the boss, you don't have to, whatever the other person, your subordinate say, you don't have to simply ignore, right? Because of your ego or whatever you feel. You can see what is the situation, what is right for the situation, and act accordingly. That is your choice. Na? You don't have to blindly, you know, look at something because you have the authority, you can act according to your own wish. You don't have to have that kind of a stand. You can take an easy stand and see what is right for the situation. So that way you can handle it. This is just one way of looking at it. You can handle it, you know, in your own way, whichever you find you feel it is fit for your situation.
For the enlightened person, for a liberated person, will the ego will not hurt them? Will ego doesn't come for them, hurt yeah. them?
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. So hurt is again an emotion. Yeah. You're talking about happening here, right?
Yeah.
So here we have anyway accepted once enlightenment, you have understood that we don't have any control. We have accepted everything. whether you call it as ego or hurt, anger, stress, anxiety, whatever name you give, is an emotion or thought. Whatever is happening here beyond our control, we have accepted that it is not under our control. So we don't have any role to play here. Everything is correct. If whatever happens is correct only. Whatever happens is we are not rejecting anything, completely accepting everything. So only the external actions, physical actions is what we have to focus.
Because there, I used to see the Saravanan and the other person sitting together every time. In any organization, I had been in many other spiritual organization also. In hierarchy or something, while speaking, and there will be a egoistic clash of and all. But when I see here Babulaji and the other Saravananji and other persons are there and yourself are coordinating very well and the organization is going on. That's what I'm just asking again. Will it not do something for the enlightened person? Is that the person with you who are in hurt with ego and left the organization or continuing with the ego clashes and all?
So that's what, so once we come to that understanding, once you come to that understanding, obviously your focus will shift to the external action. We will not worry whether it is there or not. We will not be even bothered because anyway, this chapter is completely closed, right? Ego, whatever it is, ego, anger, or jealousy, whatever happens, it is complete acceptance here. So we will not be even looking into it, whether ego comes now or not. Only if you monitor and keep checking with the lens, then you will be checking all that, right? So here what we are saying is you don't even have to check. You don't have any role here. Your role will be only in the external actions. So people like you, all these people you said, we will be focusing on our actions, how to do this in a better way. That's all. Whether it hurts or not, we, you know, we are not going to look at that. We are not going to care about that. How to do this action in a better way. That's the only objective.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Raghunath from Qatar. Mute, unmuting.
Sir, good evening. Sir, thanks for giving a lot of chance. Sorry to ask again question.
Yeah.
There is actually some cassette I see in our IR, some cassettes. In that one, subconscious mind and the other mind, what is that? Adimanam, Almanam, Adukilirundu Vara Unarmanam, Unarchigal. Idu vandu namma control illa abdingra mari sonanga. In that one, Unarmanam, Unarchi abdingrathu vandu thoughts and thinking abdingra oru doubt. Second one, the second question is the jealous thoughts or comparison, whatever the momentarily comings, and even we do some external action, momentarily it gives immediate do like that, some negative command it will give and stop it. No, the momentarily coming the actions, no, so we need to ignore it sometimes, I understand. So these are all coming from internally, unconsciously, am I right? So this whatever the jealous thoughts or expectation thoughts or like momentarily, if I wanted to talk to that guy nicely, but immediately that show, oh, he will be adamant, he will not give like that, some negative it will come and we reacted. Now I understand he should not react like that. Actually, he will be good on that one, that mind, other end. The mind itself, the corrupted, it will say that no, he will be wrong. Rudely talk like that, internally talk, that rude internal talk coming to action and made mistake and all. So the three questions, sir. So the that is comparison. Other thing, these thoughts, other thoughts, whatever the thoughts, it is internal, it will come and go. We no need to react. And whatever the when we take some external things, when we want to decide the internally also, it will sometimes it is giving its wrong information, wrong result. We have to identify and ignore it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So unarmanam unarchi. Yeah. So unarmanam is the conscious mind that we are talking about. So whatever happens, even though in the subconscious mind, we will only be aware. We can only come to know of it only when it comes to the conscious level, our conscious mind. So that is what is called the unarmanam. Unarchi is just emotions, that's all. Whatever you feel, again, whatever you experience are the emotions. That's the thing. and whatever is happening in the subconscious mind, whatever. So as I said, you know, only when it comes to the conscious portion, you will be able to recognize whatever is in the subconscious mind. You don't even have access to it. You will only be able to recognize when it comes in the conscious portion. So yes, whatever emotions, thoughts comes, you don't have any. Ignore means, again, here it is not an action because you cannot do anything. It is not out of your choice. It is choiceless. You don't have a choice to do anything there. Right? So that is what we are saying.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, one more question that what I ask now. When I want to do some action, immediately the inner mind will come. It is saying negative. I understand. Something now, it is stopping. Now I understand many. Now when I realize myself, it happened, it made me wrong to do. So I have to consciously avoid it. Am I right?
Yeah. Avoid means focus consciously, be on the external action.
Okay. What will be the consequence?
Yeah, correct.
Exactly.
If you made some mistakes in the past, you can be automatically, it will kind of alert you, right? That you should be careful now this time.
Sorry, sir. Not I am external last mistake. Now, I wanted to talk to that guy some good news also. He called me and miscall. I want to call them, talk to him. What he will talk like that? So, negative thoughts immediately will come. You mind to say that action. Immediately negative comes and we're coming through auto actions. See, the thoughts immediately, the whatever the external also, sometimes what will happen, that good or bad, the bad will come and immediately we take action like this. So it will give bad results because of ignorance that we are giving, not giving that moment. Okay, what is the consequence not given? So now I have to stop it and give. Okay, it will also tell wrong also, the thoughts for the action also, whatever it is, the thoughts also will come wrong. So I have to be ignore what you said, that understand that one. So again, concentrate externally and
wrong. Yeah, wrong in the sense, mind will give you, as I was explaining, it will give you various options. It will give you, say, for example, some five options it will give you for a given situation, what you need to do. So you have to choose whatever is the best among all those five. Everything may be, it may not be an yes, no, a completely 1-0 situation. You may not be able to completely say this is the only right thing, all these are wrong. It may be, there may be gray areas, there may be plus and minus for each of them. So that you have to decide what is right for the situation. Only the choices will come from these mind or thoughts or subconscious, whatever you can call. But decision has to be by the intellect. Okay. You have to weigh the pros and cons and decide on one of the options. Then take that action accordingly.
Okay, sir. So that means finally it will be like an open mind to deal with external.
Yeah, that's okay. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm muting it now. Senthil from Singapore, he has come.
Good evening, Babalal, sir. Good evening, Anand, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, my question actually is related to Mr. Sudhi's question. Sir, I used to mark people, actually, not directly, outside. So if I don't like, for example, someone, I used to talk to somebody else. It's kind of gossiping, but I used to tell they won't do these things well, because I used to do it and it was, very nicely done, and these guys have no idea what they are doing. So it's basically finding fault, talking something bad about, not directly to my close people. But I'm still doing that, actually. I realize that sometimes, though I want to avoid that, I'm still doing that, despite, these things are not really good things to do. So, despite the understanding, the external activity still seems to continue. So there is a bit of an ego-related activity happening on the outer side. So, is there anything that I can do, or is it just that I need to realize along the way and correct?
Yeah. So if I understand correctly, you're talking about making judgments on people, right? Without
yes, exactly. Yeah, that's open. Right. That's right. Yeah.
So when you say you are doing it, even if I do not want to do it, it happens, right? That's what.
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, which means it is not under your control, right? You are not doing it actually, right? Because if you have a choice, you will not do it, right? So which means it happens on its own. Just ignore. You don't have to worry. That's how mind is working. That's all. Mind functions in that way. Sometimes it is also needed. All these judgment also. Sometimes it will be a positive way also. It will be needed sometimes, right? Only when you suppose last time you must have met that person, You must have had some bad experience. So next time when you meet that person, automatically it'll alert you, right? Oh, last time he did something. Suppose he cheated on you, like for example, right? So it'll immediately alert you. At least next time you will be careful. Oh, okay, now I'll be careful. This time at least I'll not let him cheat. So this image or this judgment is also needed. Na? It is not that it is always negative. It is needed. But that is why I said it is our intellect which has to take the call finally. Is that even if you say...
Maybe I'll give you the actual example.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was leading a team and I was giving some work for them to do. Mm-hmm. Now after that, I have given up that role. Someone else has taken over that role. So now whatever they do, I try to find fault. Because mm-hmm. I'm not in that role, I don't want to do that either. But mm-hmm. I'm still trying to find fault or talk something about them. Which is not really good to talk something bad about others, whether in front or outside. But it's just happening sometimes. Is it because I have built my ego that much and it gets hurt when someone does nice thing also, I'm not able to accept that? Is it because of that? And that habitual thing is still there despite my understanding, yes, these are not nice things to do. Despite understanding that, yes, there is nothing much I can do internally, but only externally I need to do. That clash is always there. So this understanding remains an understanding, but my external activities also remain as they are without seeing any improvement. So that's what I want that
so,
to get some clarity.
If I understand correctly, it is about talking ill about somebody, talking bad about somebody, right?
Yes.
Since you do not like them or whatever reasons, right? Right?
Yeah.
So, it could be a habit that must have got developed from your beginning or whatever reasons. So, if you start fighting with it, again, you will only develop it more and more. Because there, your contribution should, only if you're open, only if you're flexible, then you are giving an opportunity to recreate or recreate that system or your habit also, right? If you're open, if you start being open and more liquid and in a flowing state, then only that you are allowing that to pass through. Then you can form new opinions, new images, new judgments, all that things. You have to allow that to pass through, right? If you are adamant and if you are holding to that, then it will keep on be with you. So the only thing is, don't judge this also. Don't even try to say that, you know, this is having a, don't try to fight with it, that's all. Even if this habit is with you, just accept that, okay, this is there. Next time, let me see if possible, whenever possible, I'll try to correct it. I'll be better in my activities. So just keep on, just keep reminding that only. I mean, try to be mindful of that. That's all. I mean, you don't fight with it. Because the more you fight with it, it will be only more, you will be only feel more tortured by this, right? More, it will only be more forceful. So don't try to fight with it. The only way it will be helpful is allow that to flow. Allow that to also to flow. You will only when we are in a liquid state, in a flowing mode, then all these things also will flow. Your habits also may change after some time. That also may, there is a possibility, right?
Okay. So whenever such a thought comes, I just need to allow it to realize it and stop there if possible. Is that what you mean? Or just allow it to flow? So sometimes it happens. You know, only after I do that, then I realize, I have done that. So in such cases, let it be like that. And if in case I realize that, yes, I'm going to talk something about, then I stop there. Is that correct? Is that a correct approach?
Yeah. So if it has already happened, then you cannot do anything. Nah? Whatever happened has already happened. You don't have any control.
Yeah, yeah.
Only wherever you have to do now that you are, because see, once you're thinking on these lines, obviously next time when it happens, it'll automatically alert you. When you're thinking something, when you're thinking of acting in this way, automatically there will be an alert in your system, right? You will think that, oh, now I'm going to do this. Should I do this or not? That question will automatically come. So at that point, you can decide whatever is right for that situation. If you yourself feel that this is wrong, this is not apt for the situation and it is not right for me to act in the situation, then you have to stop it, right? When you are consciously doing it. But when it happens unconsciously, without even your own control, then you cannot do anything. Now, only thing is, don't fight with it. By fighting with it, you will only be more unconscious, right? You will only be in friction with it. So allow it to flow. Only when things are in a flowing mode, you are giving an opportunity to correct. like a river. I used to give that example always, right? In a river stream, some places there may be, you may be even mixing the drainage water flow, right? And the same river, after flowing through, it will get cleared, it will get cleaned up on its own. If you keep on holding that water, if it water gets stagnated in that same place, then that drainage water, then it will become a dirty water. But if you allow it to flow on its own natural way, then it will get cleaned up also, right? Same, water gets settled, right? If you allow it to flow, things will automatically get settled.
Thank you.
Okay, so done. So it is quite some time now, 8:50 now. So we will wind up now. So on behalf of all the participants, I thank Anandji for his nice explanations and guidance. Thank you very much.
Thank you all.
So I am